is your fortress, your high tower, your refuge you can hide, and your solid rock. You can stand on this rock. You never shaken. You never be in the shadow of. Oh, hallelujah, praise the Lord. Thank you, Lord. Oh, my hope is built on nothing else than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not the trust the sweetest frame, but only lean on Jesus' name, on Christ the solid rock I stand. All of the ground is sinking sand. All of the ground is sinking sand. I know you built a house, which is your faith, on the solid rock, which is Jesus Christ. You will stand on the faith on this rock, Jesus Christ. You believe, you trust. Oh, thank you, Lord. Even it rains down, storm arose, hurricane, tornado, earthquake, your house will never fall down, because you built on the solid rock. Oh, hallelujah, praise the Lord. Oh, my Lord. Last Sunday, 24, was Pentecost Day. Holy Spirit came on this day. We, as a Christian, will celebrate the first outpouring of the Holy Spirit to the disciple of Jesus Christ. You know, we cry out in prayer to the Lord, we believe. Give me more. Oh, I want to listen more power of the Holy Spirit. I want to get the more, you know, the something I need. More. We used to pray to the Lord. One of the most constant cries of Christian in prayer from every tradition is more. More. And this is as it should be. We should desire more intimacy, more depth, more power, more faith, more strength, more miracle. We should desire to obtain these things we are asking. Listen, I want to tell you. Now I have a question, my brother and sister. And yet, the question is remained. How? How do I get the thing we want by the Lord? How do we experience more? How? Here is the answer. Holy Spirit is key, master key to a supernatural life and ministry and Jesus concept and answer. We cry out the more only we can receive the answer and the thing we are asking through the Holy Spirit. He is the entrance into the human history as a man. The Gospel of John 1 chapter 14, flesh, word became the flesh, was by the power of the Holy Spirit. I will not give the scripture concerning of this matter. I'm speaking to you. In Luke 1 chapter 26:35, angel of Gabriel was sent by the Lord to Virgin Mary, who is praised to be married named Joseph. Angel said, you have highly favored by the Lord. God is with you. Oh, hallelujah. I'm telling you, you are favored, highly favored by the Lord, like Maria. Okay, the angel goes on to speak to Maria. Maria was shocked. What? How greetings might be? The angel said, you will be with child, you give birth a boy. He will be great. You are to give name Jesus. Jesus. He Lord God will give throne, Father, David. He will reign over the throne, Jacob's house. He will be called Son of Most High. Maria said, "How can this be? Since I am virgin." Listen. My friend, angel said, "Holy Spirit will upon you." Hallelujah. Oh my Lord. The power of Holy Spirit will overshade you. The Holy One to be born will be Son of God. Hallelujah. Amen. Holy Spirit now. Same Holy Spirit. Maria was given by God. Thank God. This Holy Spirit will empower you to you now. Hallelujah. Because you are listening my word. Okay. He will be Son of God. We believe. As Peter confessed, Jesus asked the disciple, "Who do people say some Son of Man is?" Some say, Baptist John. Others say Elijah, Jeremiah, one of the prophets. Jesus said, "What about you? Who do you say I am?" Peter said, "You are the Son of the Living God." Hallelujah. Matthew 16:16. Oh my. "You are the Son of God." Just the same you confess. Hallelujah. Amen. Oh my. Oh, help me, Holy Spirit. Touch me. Oh, thank you, Lord. So, Jesus Christ, God, you are blessed. Listen, this was not revealed by man, but my Father. Peter is rock. Jesus Christ gave to other name, Peter. From the Simon, he changed Peter. Gate of Hades will not overcome. Oh, mama. Oh, you don't want to hear. Oh, I stay again. Oh, thank you, Lord. Gate of Hades will not overcome. Church will not be overcome by the evil, evil forces. The Jesus said, I will give you the key. Whatever you lose on earth will be lost in heaven. Whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. You know, Acts 2 tells the Holy the story of Pentecost. My point of view today to preaching to you is Pentecost. But what does Pentecost mean? Acts 2 highlights 3 outstanding traits. First, God-centered. The ideology of our age, this generation, is naturalism, materialism. People this age think about the firstly material, money, green money. They don't care spirit. They are not interested in other things except the material, which reduce everything to material cause and effect. It leaves no room for God. There's no room to enter into God, to their mind, their heart. And they mocks humanity's spiritual desire, spiritual longing. Pentecost are God-centered. We believe the ultimate experience of everything that happens is God, our Father in heaven. That's it. I'm sure He walks through the natural order, you know, as I see with me. But nature cannot be reduced to this manner. It must be explained in terms of the God who declares the world, revelation. God proclaimed through the mouth of the prophet, who is a pastor now, some spiritual leader. The word which was spoken by the mouth of the person to whom God loves, God is going to use. God say, I'll pour out my spirit on all people in the last day. Okay, secondly, Jesus focused. Pentecostal believe that Jesus is God's solution for humanity's all problem. Jesus Christ's answer. That's it. No other answer to our problem you have. Only answer is Jesus Christ. He's gonna give to you it correct answer to you over the problem you have or you could not solve in your effort. You know, he's a healer. He is baptized by Spirit. Oh, thank you. He's a Messiah. We are waiting. He will come and establish his kingdom. Yes, he will come soon. Look at the world now. We see the sign of the end of this world every day. Thirdly, Spirit empowered. The default setting too many churches in our age is nominalism. There are many denominations. There are denominations exist now. I could not count number of denomination in Christian church. I'm talking about the Christian church, not other religion. The Bible says, 2 Timothy chapter 5. Listen, gang. Having a form of holiness, but denying its power. Might follow me. They are not interested in the Holy Spirit. They ignore of Holy Spirit. They don't speak holy word. They don't speak the word of God because Holy Spirit is not in him. I give you the scripture. Luke 6, chapter 46, 45. The good tree bear bad fruit, nor does a bad tree bear good fruit. Every tree is recognized its fruit, and a good man bring the good thing out of the good store up in his heart. Bad man, evil man bring forth the evil thing out of in evil store up in his heart. Listen. So out of overflow in his heart, his mouth speaks. He is a mouth speaker. I know you speak good word, positive word, and the word of God, because Holy Spirit is working inside you. It makes sense? Oh, hallelujah. I know. Because you want to preach good news, you want to talk in the word of God to other people, because you've been store of the good thing in your heart. Oh, hallelujah, praise God. That spirit empowered. Spirit has been empowered to you because you love God. I want to wrap up of this sermon today. God sent us Jesus focused spirit empowered. That is my message today. That's all. This message is all about the Pentecost. Hallelujah. I can't wait the next time. Because I see you want to preach the good word, the gospel, because you are fulfilled by the Holy Spirit, because you just have heard it, my message. Holy Spirit is working until we go to heaven. Hallelujah. See you later next time. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you. Praise the Lord. Bye-bye.